Hi, I'm Gerald.
And today we're going to be doing a little bit of myth busting around COVID. So, Gerald, can you still get COVID-19 by interacting with individuals who are vaccinated already?
Well, that's a great question. It's really kind of a bit of a myth, because once you're fully vaccinated, the chances of being infected at all are reduced by 75%. And even people who do get infected after being fully vaccinated, the fact of the matter is there's actually very little virus that we see these people shedding. So the risk that they're going to transmit the virus is actually dramatically reduced. Some of my colleagues have suggested as high as 85% reduction in transmission if you're fully vaccinated. Here's one for you, Sam. There will be restrictions on campus for individuals who have not yet received both doses of the vaccine.
So at this time, the university doesn't plan on any restrictions for individuals based on vaccination status. The faculty will be aware of who is or isn't vaccinated and will be forcing everyone to get vaccinated.
Oh yeah, that's a big myth. Lots of things about vaccination relate to your rights as an individual and the privacy of your information, particularly medical information. So there's no list being kept of who's vaccinated and who's not vaccinated. And really importantly, I think everyone knows, you cannot be forced to take a vaccine. That is an individual choice. We really encourage you to get vaccinated. Absolutely, we think it's incredibly important and vital, but it is your right to refuse a vaccination for reasons, you know, that are reasonable to yourself and to others. It may be unsafe to return to campus if you've only received one dose of the vaccine.
Well, so I would say that's kind of not really true on its own. We've seen that campus has been a pretty safe place on with regards to COVID when everyone's following all the rules around mask usage and social distancing. And so we're going to continue doing that into the fall until we get guidance that it's safe to stop doing those things, which means that we're going to be able to continue to prevent transmission on campus with everything else we're doing. Vaccination is just part, one piece of the puzzle in terms of reducing transmission. I can still get COVID-19 if I'm vaccinated, specifically from exposure to variants.
So that's a little bit of a myth. You have to put it in perspective. As I already mentioned, if you're fully vaccinated, the likelihood that you will actually even get infected with the virus is reduced by at least 75% from what we know from all the current vaccines. What's surprising is that although a couple of the variants, Beta and Delta, have some reduction in the amount of protection you get from a vaccine, you actually still are protected from it. And in fact, there's good studies to show that if you've had both vaccine shots, the reduction in getting COVID or getting severe COVID is dramatically reduced. Somewhere in the neighborhood of 90%+. So if you're vaccinated, it's actually really hard to get COVID. But if you do, it's going to be a very mild illness because these vaccines are incredibly effective. Sufficient ventilation is the most important control for COVID-19 in all of the university and faculty of health science buildings.
I think that's a pretty big myth. I mean, ventilation, let's be clear, is very important for health in general and for transmission of other communicable diseases. And we are optimizing it in our buildings across campus. Things are happening now to get our buildings ready and in the right state for everybody to be returning to campus. But that said, ventilation alone will not really prevent transmission. It needs to be paired with the other interventions that we've already talked about, specifically masking and vaccination. And if we can get our vaccination rates sky high, which is the goal, then ventilation will be so minuscule in comparison to that in terms of preventing transmission. Now that our vaccination rates are increasing, which is great, mask wearing is no longer necessary.
Oh yeah, this has got to be one of the most interesting ones that are out there. So masks are still necessary. We're really transitioning from a world where masks are one of our most important primary defenses, along with all those other public health measures, to a time when if we have a sufficient number of people vaccinating the population, they may become less important. But we're in a transition at the moment. Masks need to continue to be worn in certain circumstances to prevent transmission. You may be surrounded by other people who are either not vaccinated, perhaps have only one vaccine and are not fully vaccinated. And we do know that crowded spaces and closed spaces, there's a probability of transmission because of that close proximity. And so masks are going to be worn. But what we're going to see is a slow phase out of mask wearing. But that may take literally the next year to get us to a level where we were in the post-pandemic world. And I would editorialize that it's very possible possible that in the future during winter respiratory virus seasons, people may go back to wearing masks as they do in many parts of the world, just to prevent the transmission of viruses, because one of the offshoots of all this mask wearing and stuff has been a reduction in influenza and a lot of cold.
Yeah. I haven't gotten sick in months. It's awesome.
Me too. COVID-19 is easily transferred by surfaces.
I think all the data we have at this point shows that it's really more spread between individuals rather than through surfaces. But that said, keeping our surfaces clean is still important because we know a lot of other viruses are spread through contact. And so washing your hands, keeping your surfaces clean will help prevent you from getting sick, and then you won't have to wonder whether it's COVID or not.
So anyways, hopefully these little myth busts have helped. We really appreciate if you guys want to talk about them with your friends and family, so they're aware of these answers as well.
Yeah, spread the word.